I want T.J. Cooper and Derek Ray to come on down here. Come here. Come on, get over here. We wouldn't be here now were it not for these two guys. And or maybe we would, but it'd be 5 years from now. But an amazing thing happened. And a big round of applause for them. And then I'll share with you the story. Client of mine reserves a domain name. Another client of mine pushes this idea of launching a website. And there's a whole fiasco with the whole .com phenomenon, and it's another great story, but I won't launch into that because this is a more important one that I have you two here. And the first website, the first posting was a WOD, was a workout of the day. And a buddy of mine who's a .com guru, mogul, brought over this 66 megahertz Cluj dusty crap machine that had been sitting in his garage. And the missus saw it and said, that thing's not coming in the house. I mean, it was filthy. So we put it out in the garage and put a keyboard up on top of it. And he's like, type, and then hit enter, and you'll have a website. And we're like, wow, you know, this is amazing. So we put out a workout. And because it looked cool, the first site was about the color of Matt's shirt there. Raise your hand, Matt. It was blue. And of course, the only font you could read on that, the only type you could read on that text would be white. And so it was blue like that. It's hideous, I know, with white. And we were like, whoa, look at it. I mean, I got the brightest website on the internet. And no phone number, address, email, nothing, just a WOD, just workout. And we were pumping it out there into the universe. It's kind of like SETI, the search for extraterrestrial intelligence. We're like, you know, someone's going to do these workouts and be impacted and do them again and tell others, and it's going to spread, was the notion, which actually drew considerable laughter and derision from world-class authorities on building websites. And we were pumping these things out there for about 6 months. And one day the phone rang in the gym. And Lauren answers it, and he was interrupting classes, and it was Derek Ray. And Derek, let's hear the version from your end of things. How the fuck did you find us?
Well, actually, one of the cops came in, Mike Hyde, who's one of our sergeants on the SWAT team, came in and he says, hey, check this blue screen of death out. And I'm like, what do you mean blue screen of death? So I started looking at it, tinkering with it. At the time, I had a recruit class. So I said, hey, you know, this is kicking my butt. If it's kicking my butt, it'll definitely kick recruits' butts. So I took half my class, split half my class up, and started making half of them do CrossFit. And I made the other half pretty much do your traditional PT. And that's when I kind of got Sergeant Cooper involved, T.J. Cooper, if you guys don't know him. He started coming out, and we were tinkering with it a little bit, you know, and we were looking at it, going, hey, man, this is killing these kids. But they're becoming animals at the same time. And the CrossFit kids were just eating the non-CrossFit kids for lunch. And I say non-CrossFit, I mean, they were doing traditional PT. Hey, we'd take them out, and we'd run them long distance, and we'd make them do pull-ups and push-ups. Why would we do that? Because it's easy. It's easy to control. You don't have to be an exercise and fitness guru to take a person out and say, hey, run. Hey, do push-ups. Hey, do pull-ups. But we really weren't doing much anything for that crew. The CrossFit crew was doing functional movement. You know, we were messing around with the three metabolic pathways, which you guys will learn ad nauseum. And it works. The stuff works. So I gave them a call. I talked to Lauren on the phone, and I was just giddy. I mean, I was like, hey, did you come up with this? And she's like, yeah, we did. And I'm like, this is the greatest thing since sliced bread. And she said, bread? Don't be eating bread.
She put me on the phone. I had nothing to say to the kid. I was like, this guy's kind of weird, you know? And I was like, how did he find us? I'm still not clear on that. And then later we got the idea of putting like contact information out, because I'd like to hear from more of these weird people doing this thing. But he was telling me like, these workouts make people sick. I'm like, yeah, we know, you know? And they're really hard, and talk about soreness. And it was the contact from a distant galaxy. I had always been able to regionally impact one-on-one. But see, the problem is I'd work with you, John, and amazing things would happen to you, and you'd go try and talk to Topaz about it, and he'd give one of two reactions. Either you're a fucking freak, I don't want anything to do with you and your fitness, or you're a genetic marvel, and therefore what you're telling me has no relevance to me. And that scene played out over and over again for decades. Very hard thing to communicate. We're going to help with that process here today. But there's another piece to this, and that is that the fine folks at Jacksonville Sheriff's Office, Florida National Police Corps, had me out here to do a seminar. I would have called it our first certification, but there are no certifications to be had. That idea hadn't been forced down our throats yet. So I came out here to do a seminar, and we figured out the date, sir. It was January 2002. And we launched the website in February 2001. So I came out here in 2002, and we didn't call for this room. We got stuck in a little classroom down the hall. Upstairs?
Upstairs.
Upstairs in the corner?
Yeah, the tiniest one.
Yeah, and we had 50 people in there and me. And they're like, okay, teach us all CrossFit. And maybe four or five pairs of dumbbells that we had to take outside. And it was just this unbelievable clusterfuck. I couldn't believe it. But I was spreading the word, right, doing the missionary work. I was just lucky they didn't eat me alive, the locals. But it was a good experience. And out of that came the phone call 6 months later. Got the call from guys that said that they had been asked by the U.S. Justice Department to get us come out and get a CrossFit certification. And I told him that we don't have a certification. He goes, no, that would be the whole reason we're coming out, this thick Southern accent. He's like, whoa, it was forceful. The guy had been a PT director at the FBI, and like, you know, you could feel that over the phone. He's like, it was born.